Hello there, my music lovers, I'm Joshua with the File Heaven, and today we are having a look at speakers. Those are the Edifier E25 or Luna speakers. Those are like the moon sounds like, and the moon doesn't sound very good this time around. They have a pretty terrible overall sound, but the design is beautiful. You cannot tell me that you don't like them. I mean, be honest about it, you really like them. And I like them too. The design is absolutely beautiful, and it is the reason I bought them. I originally bought them for about $200, but the more time passes, the more prices grow for the guys at Edifier, despite them offering a pretty poor value and despite them offering a pretty poor overall service. All in all, they just keep increasing the prices without offering anything in return, so I'm not a big fan of the guys at Edifier for that. On the other hand, the products themselves are fairly good. The speaker is still a pretty good value, although at $300 there are many other options that you may consider. If you are being honest about it, for $300 you could get some pretty good speakers, although they would have to be passive. If you are looking for active speakers or speakers that have an amplifier built inside, and those do have an amplifier built inside, even a DAC, they are going to be a bit less in quality. As you can see, I keep sliding my hand inside this little slit here because the speakers actually gather a ton of dust, and the surface inside there is very dusty. Although they have a pretty interesting design, they also have many flows. They have no flow quite as bad as the S1000DB from Edifier. That pair of speakers had a really major flow in the fact that they had a hole in them, and every time the bass would hit, they would go like foo, foo, foo. I had to deal with that, and I didn't remain a big fan of the guys at Edifier, even after them not wanting to solve the warranty. Although they were in warranty, officially and legally in Romania, no good guys at Edifier. You should be more careful about your customers. The E25 though, this speaker, looks pretty cool, and the sound is what I would call punchy. They have a lot of punch. The sound is very quick. They don't have a lot of bass down low, so the bass kind of rolls off at 80 decibels. That is very high, and you can feel that they lack a lot of the sub bass. They have even less bass than the Aurender S5W, which I have there in the back, the ones on the top, the black ones. The Aurender has way, way more bass than the Edifier. This Edifier is very shy in terms of bass. That being said, the sound is very quick, the bass is very, very fast. It can keep up with any type of music, and they punch really nicely. You can feel their punch right in your chest. Can feel the bass punching you. That being said, you can really hear the bass lacking substance. The sound doesn't really have a lot of authority, and the sound can be a bit flaky in general. The detail is fairly good. I mean, I thought the detail was good at $200, considering what you can get as far as headphones go for even less than $200. And considering that they cost $300 right now, at least this is the price I could find in Romania, they are a terrible overall deal. They are not a good deal, and I will not be afraid to tell you this. They have two passive speakers in the back, and one of them is on the top and one of them is in the bottom, right inside this slit, as you can see here. The two passive radiators kind of create that punchy sound, and instead of the bass being the slow boomy type, it is a quick and pretty enjoyable bass. So overall, I wouldn't complain about the bass. I will complain about their maximum volume. You see, you can listen to them pretty loud, and up until a certain loudness, everything is fine. When you reach and when you approach their maximum volume, they start to distort really, really badly. You can hear the sound being extremely distorted. Also, they start having a very weird kind of whistling in the background. You can hear an going at all times, so that is very unpleasant, and you cannot really keep them at the maximum volume for long periods of time. Those are some major flaws in their design. The analog part, the amplifier, really doesn't keep up with the speaker. The Bluetooth part is even worse, and if you imagined that you can purchase those and listen to Bluetooth, you are absolutely wrong. They sound terrible on Bluetooth, and I would not approach the Bluetooth connection under any circumstances. It is just terrible. Don't listen to them on Bluetooth. At least for me, I found the Bluetooth to be really terrible. Every single type of drum hit and of bass line sounds kind of like this. They have this sound which you can hear when touching the driver, and I'll try to show it to you. That is how you expect every single drum to sound like, and that type of sound kind of punches you in the chest, but at the same time you can feel that it lacks the low-end extension compared to other speakers. On the high-end they extend pretty well up to 8 kHz, so not a lot of treble either. You can EQ them quite a bit, and I have been EQing them to enjoy them a bit more. After EQing they sound pretty good, the detail improves a lot. On original they are a bit smooth in the treble, a bit too rolled off in the bass. Overall they are not a great speaker in any way, but they have a beautiful aesthetic design, and I would say this. If you need a speaker that will just play something in the background, if you don't need a lot of resolution, they will do just fine. They won't make anyone cry when hearing a guitar, and they won't impress you with their beautiful sounds, but they will impress you on how beautiful they are. And just look at this ergonomic. This is the type of speaker that you want to present to someone. Say someone comes to you and asks you, whoa, what are those speakers? And you can brag about them. But when you turn them on, you better pray that that person is not an audiophile or a true music lover, because he will notice all the shortcomings. I just realized I haven't presented the package quite yet, so let's get down to that. So they come with their own power brick. They have a full-sized power brick for this speaker in particular. They also have an extension cable, so the cable between the power outlet and the speaker is very long. You have way more than enough length. It is not a build issue. You can also purchase those 2-pin cables very easily off of any place in the entire world. So it shouldn't be hard to find replacement for the cable or to get them longer. The cable that connects the two speakers is a very proprietary format. I have never seen those 6-pin formats before, and you will not be able to find the replacement cable. The length between the two speakers is about 2 meters to 3 meters. It is not very long, as you can see. It is just 2 of my arms stretched. So if you need them set further apart, you will not be able to do so with the default cable. And I am pretty sure you are not going to find those anywhere. It is a very unique looking cable. On the other hand, the happy part is that with their sound and with their overall design, you should never have to place them further apart. If you have to place them further apart, just go for another speaker. And I'm not even joking, it is not a great speaker, and it is made to be listened quite a bit closer. On the soundstage part, they have a pretty fair soundstage, and if you set them well, they don't really care about being too close to a wall. If you set them even right back to the wall, they will sound pretty much the same as being located anywhere. They just need about 1 to 2 meters of space. In 2 meters of space, they will generate a beautiful kind of soundstage. They'll have a pretty fair amount of instrument separation, and they'll have a pretty enjoyable sound too. So as long as you don't really mess up the placement very badly, they are going to sound pretty good and up to their maximum. Speaking of maximum, this is the cable you are going to use to connect them to a source, and it is the only way to connect them to a source that doesn't sound incredibly bad. And this is a 3.5 mm jack to 3.5 mm jack. You can find those pretty much everywhere. The default cable is fairly good. It is not the thing that holds them back. On the other hand, I have noticed that this cable has a pretty good overall sound. If you connect something to this end, it is going to sound pretty good, but I will not invest in a source for them. They don't really care about the source, they don't scale a lot. The overall sound can be a bit too thick, despite not having the low end, and it can have that boomy bass, although they don't really have that kind of depth to become boomy in the true sense. So overall, you are kind of avoiding all of the issues that you typically get with a proper speaker. You are getting a pretty balanced overall sound, kinda, but it would be very good if you could find them for $150. For the current price of $300, they are a no-go. You could go with many other speakers, like the Audio Engine A5 Plus. There are many options for $300, and I'm not even joking. Those are not a great deal for $300, but for $150, especially if locally they can be found for that price, or if you can find them on second hand, they would make a pretty sweet deal, especially with their overall looks. I mean, just think about it. You have those speakers, you present them to someone, you give someone a tour of your house, they are going to be impressed. They are going to think, oh, this man has taste. And that is what they look. They look like a tasteful pair of speakers. They really look pretty tasty, and I won't really chew them or take a bite out of them, but they don't look bad at all. They are a bit dusty because they gather dust, they are a dust magnet. They don't get scratched quite that easily. So despite this surface looking pretty scratch prone, it is not actually pretty scratch prone, it is pretty scratch resistant. And that is a pleasing thing about them. They even have touch controls on one of the speakers. As you can see here, they have a volume up, a volume down, and an on-off switch. That is everything. The Bluetooth is turned on at all times. You cannot turn it off, and anyone who wants to connect to them will connect to them. So if you have a lot of friends who would sometimes play a prank on you, just take care to turn off the speakers at night so that you don't find yourself listening to some loud music while you are sleeping. Only the right speaker has all the connections. And as you can see, the right speaker is doing all of the decoding job and such, so you actually have a pretty fair amount of fun with them. As you can see, they actually take good care of details. They even managed to write a lot on the bottom of the right speaker. And that kind of makes me curious why they are the type of company who will never solve warranty issues. You are purchasing those without warranty, and at this point I am not trusting Edifier to provide warranty, unless they will at some point contact and let me know what happened with my mails, because I sent them a few about my S1000DB. They never replied, they never wanted to solve my issues, so yeah. For the E25 I had no real issues, so all of the issues are part of their design, they were not build issues, they are not something that you can solve in a warranty situation. They look pretty cool. They don't weigh quite that much, they are easy to carry around. The package is also very good for portability. I had the package, I kind of lost it because this is a personal pair. I thank you for watching this video review. I hope you have enjoyed it. I hope you'll consider subscribing to my YouTube channel. Also press like on this video if you enjoyed the video. I hope you have a lovely Kinder and let's see each other really soon. Bye bye.